Hey, what's up, guys? Welcome to episode 3 of King of the Hill, and in this episode, we're going to be taking a look at the P90. And if you take a look at the scoreboard, we got ourselves, again, a new king. We have yet to have a repeat offender, and this time, we've got Akuma who won. He had 108 kills, and in second place, we had EJ. He had 101 kills. I came in third this time with 82. We had, after that, Andy with 75, Wes with 67, and Phoenix, she went from queen to the Joker. And so she finished dead last with 59 kills. So let's go ahead and get started on our conversation about the P90. All right, well, Akuma, how did you use the P90? The P90B.
Oh, I got the holographic sight. Put on the flash suppressor. And I guess that's it. What else do you need to put on? Oh, the laser sight?
What else do you need to put on it? He's like, there are three attachments, right?
Hold on. Oh yeah, so it's a holographic laser sight and flash suppressor.
Oh okay.
Love how the current 100 doesn't know what he put on.
Like
what? How many?
Like I'm staring at three screens right now, so I'm like, what the hell?
You can do that? You can put three attachments on?
Like three? Hold on. And yeah, so that's basically it. So I basically throughout the whole King of the Hill thing, and basically 2 days prior to that, and a couple of days after that, I kept running the same attachment. So it
works for you, huh?
Yeah, it worked for me, and honestly, I didn't put it down because I fell in love with that gun.
Indeed.
It felt so comfortable, amount of bullets in there.
But don't blow this all in one load, man. We got to come back around to you.
All right, let's do this.
What about you, EJ?
The question was, how did I use it?
How did you use it?
Okay. What did you slap on that?
What did you slap on that?
What did I slap on that bitch?
Yeah.
Basically, what Akuma did, not holographic, I put a red dot sight. Laser, and I mess with flash suppressor and the suppressor, but I found the flash suppressor works best if you're trying to do like a lot of TDM and that kind of thing.
Mm-hmm.
But situational, but yeah, that's how I did it.
Oh, okay, and like Akuma, I like the holographic sight. I use the laser sight and suppressor. That's what I thought was worked best for me in my playstyle for that weapon. So let's see, who was next on the list? It was. Sorry, Andy. Andy, how'd you use the P90?
First I used the reflex sight. Mm-hmm. Is it called like that, huh? Yeah, but then I changed to the holographic sight. I don't know why. Just like it
just
more.
Just for fun.
I don't know. More. I was doing better with it, but yeah.
So you use a reflective sight, and then what else?
The laser sight and flash suppressor.
Alright. And then, Wes, how'd you use the P90?
Hollow, suppressor, laser sight.
And then...
That's about it.
Sorry, go ahead.
Oh, I was done.
Oh, okay, sorry.
Already?
Already. That was all three, right?
That was quick.
Yeah, right? He was like to the point, and then we got Akuma, the Chrono 100, just kind of like, and then there's third one, right?
I think there's tactical light.
Yeah, can I put a fourth one, a tactical light? I taped it on.
Is there a bipod?
Is there
can I remember? I don't remember.
Wait. Might as well be as long a range it can get.
It's true. What about you, Phoenix?
I use the same as Akuma. I forgot what it was. That's it. Yeah, it was the laser sight, the flash suppressor. Wow, I said it right for once.
And don't forget the bipod. Don't forget the bipod.
Yeah, and then the bipod for fun. And the holographic sight. Yeah.
You didn't use foregrip?
Yeah.
<Don't confuse me.
laughs> That's a noob move right there.
That's a new move.
Alright, so Akuma, since you won this one, how did you like the weapon?
It felt so comfortable. Getting all the ammo count on it was pretty assuring for me, because I would always run into two or three guys and we basically do the work. Feel comfortable. What else? I guess that's about it. There's nothing. I guess I would get long range, mid range, and short. All those close quarters kind of encounters I've definitely owned.
Mm-hmm.
I have. Mainly, the only negative would be like the long range kills. But I don't see anything wrong with the weapon. That's from my perspective.
So like overall, you thought as far as like it being good in like all categories? You think it's like it's, yeah. What about long range? I mean, did you think it excelled at long range, but like was adequate?
Yeah, it's a little getting used to it. Once you learn how to get used to the spread, uh-huh. if you're gonna do long range, but after a while, you just get used to it and just tap the trigger. But I find myself doing the mid range to closer range encounters doing the best. And long range it was once in a while, but it honestly performed well overall.
Overall, okay. What do you think, EJ? How do you think the weapon performed?
For what I like it, I usually run it in rush with a suppressor because I like to do the sneaky. Mm-hmm. But for what we were doing, I wasn't a huge fan of it. A lot of Congress domination. Even though it's good at it, I don't like it for that. It's a decent gun, but I just don't like it for that. But it does get pretty good range, like Akuma was mentioning. For a PDW, it is pretty good range.
Because we used it primarily in close quarters this time around.
Yes, yeah, close quarters. So for that, it's really good for that, but I don't like it.
It's good for that, but I just don't like it.
I just don't like it for that. I prefer it like as a really silent. It's a really good gun with a suppressor. So that's why I primarily just run around as a recon and rush while I'm attacking and just put beacons down and sneak behind enemies. That's how I usually use the gun.
You know, and that's the way that I found that I prefer to use the gun. When I use the P90, I know it's available for all classes, but I actually prefer to use it with the recon class because of the fact that you feel that much lighter with it. I don't know if it's just me imagining things.
It's probably just personal feel.
It might be, but I know if you put on like a squad sprint, I mean, you really can just
that
go.
That is something interesting though. Like we didn't mention like what classes did we pick? Because I myself.
Oh, I'm getting around to that at the end.
Oh, are you?
Yes.
Okay.
Nice.
I was waiting for that to like.
Are you then?
I am. Well, then let's just keep moving on. So Andy, what do you think about the gun? Oh, actually, I didn't even say what I thought. I think the gun actually worked. Well, and like in all situations, to be honest, like you could do it close range and you could do it mid range, and then it had enough long range where you could actually kill decently from long range. But it would take, you know, a handful of shots and kind of the spread wasn't all that bad, so I mean, you could start picking people off, but they started to move, so you probably didn't do a lot of damage long range, but you could do it if you laid on the trigger and someone didn't know where you're shooting from, especially if you got like a silencer on. So, what do you think, Andy?
Actually, the gun worked out for me, and I was doing good, in my opinion, I mean.
Yeah. And your very humble opinion, like, I was doing good with it.
You were in.
But, I don't know, it's probably just me, and maybe it's just because the weapon is not one of my, like, favorite PWs. I don't know, it just doesn't feel right, the gun. It feels, it feels
Belgian.
Good. I mean, it's fun to use it, and I kind of also like, but it just doesn't feel really right.
So, for your playstyle, it's not the gun of choice?
It's the gun of... It would be one of them, but... I don't know, it's just a bit of that strange feel.
I think we all have that feeling about certain guns. You just don't feel right using them. Yeah. So Wes, what do you think of this pretty P90B?
I think it's the damn M16 of every kit. You can see it everywhere. It can do everything. It's a damn try-hard weapon.
Try hard weapon. That's a very bold accusation.
That's probably why it doesn't feel right to me.
It doesn't. It doesn't feel right to me. but it does good damage at range. It has a fast fire rate, but still, and then a large ammo count. Plus, you have your laser sight and either suppressor you would like. Mm-hmm. It can do almost anything you want, and you can use it in every kit. Mm-hmm. To me, it feels like another try-hard weapon.
Ooh, strong words. Maybe you know what it is. I was gonna say. I think Andy's Russian, sensibility doesn't like it because it's just too damn easy. It must be hard. What about you, Phoenix?
Sorry, what was the question?
Oh, God.
somebody always has to ask.
Yeah, right. We should prompt you with the question in the chat. Where did the weapon excel for you? Or did it not?
No, I hated it. But then again, I think I was having a bad day, to be honest. But, because I've used the P90 before, and I've used it on close quarters, and it was with the Kuma and the rest of the gang. And I did alright with it, and that's when I was, because I remember I used a suppressor on it only. And I remember asking advice of them, and they said to use it with a flash suppressor. So that improved a lot. But, I don't feel comfortable with it. I don't think PDWs are my thing.
Mm-hmm.
I think PP2000 is more my thing because it's slower rate and, yeah.
That's Russian.
So I'm afraid it's, I don't like
it. She likes it low and slow.
Low and slow.
Shut up.
So to get her to get back around, Kumo, what class do you think you would use that weapon most often with?
I would often use it with the recon and support. I would alternate between the two classes every now and then.
So, like, why? Like, I can understand from my own perspective why recon, but why specifically support?
Just for the ammo, because since it was a pretty comfortable gun for me to use, it I didn't want to run it run out of ammo. So I would always have that comfortable feeling that I had an ammo box next to me and stuff like that. But that's mainly the two classes that I used it with. Every now and then, rarely the assault, but assault having a bunch of good weapons,
it's kind of hard to pick it over something else.
Right, so it's mainly support, and then it'll be recon.
I could see that. Yeah. What about you, EJ?
Same thing as Akuma. I usually run support just overall, but P90 would work pretty good with support just because you can give yourself ammo, resupply your team and all that. And recon, like I said before, like, because if I'm playing a lot of rush and I'm attacking, I really want to utilize the spawn beacons and, you know, get behind enemy lines, but slap a suppressor on P90 and go to work, because I've turned games around by doing that. You can ask.
Gonna put that.
You can put ask team the guys on back,
you,
huh?
You can ask the guys. Here.
So we got. Like
sometimes you can do work a lot of work with that gun.
So we got a couple. Yeah. We got a couple of guys being really humble today.
Yeah, you know, no need to be humble.
No need. I don't mean to brag or anything, but I put team on back with the P90.
I've done it, but yeah.
I would say I would only use it with the recon class because I've got other other weapons that I'd much rather use in the other kits, like Akuma was saying. And because of whatever like feel I get using it with the recon, it just feels like I move faster and it feels appropriate for that weapon, especially with the silencer. You know, you move fast, you shoot fast, you're silent, you can kind of be that pest, you know, in the enemy. Even if you're not playing close quarters, if you're playing like Rush or even Conquest, you could play that like sneaky role and just aggravate people without like having to be like in their face with, you know, like an LMG or, you know, I don't like sniper rifles anyway, so it gives me a reason to play the recon class.
Okay, I
really see it, for me it works best with the recon class, just because like I said, like Akuma said, like EJ said, there's like other weapons that I would prefer to use in the other kits before this weapon. So what do you think, Andy, what class would you use it most with if you were to use the weapon?
Yeah,
if you were, because I know you don't like it.
I mean, I don't know, it's something like a love hate thing.
Mm-hmm. Oh, okay.
Yep, but anyways, I would probably use it in the sport class because it feels like a mixture between a PW and LMG because of the ammo.
You never run out of ammo?
Yeah.
Because of the big magazine and yeah.
What do you think, Wes? What class would you use it in?
Support if we don't have any medics, just because you're going to spit through ammo so fast. Mm-hmm. And it's nice because even though you've got such a large magazine, that just means you have fewer reloads and you're just going to spit through your total ammo. But if you don't have any medics, then just run medic, because otherwise you're just going to lose so many tickets.
Yeah, that's true. What about you, Phoenix? I know you're another one who doesn't like the weapon. If you were to use it, like, what class would you, do you think you'd use it most with?
Probably support or assault. One of those two. Do I have to pick one?
What?
Do I have to pick one?
No.
Oh, no,
not at all.
Okay.
You must pick one.
I'll pick one right now.
Do I have to pick one or what the
There can be only one.
There can be only one.
It's probably, you've done that yourself. Yeah, those. Well, I say those because when I do assault, then, you know, when I'm like, you know, one-on-one combat or like 1 in 5, which is usually the case, I'm always getting bloody sandwiched somewhere. So it's like, and so I need to, like, you know, throw down a medkit, revive, whatever. And then when and sometimes I use support because, you know, as everybody knows, you know, nobody gives you ammo. So you gotta put your own ammo, don't you?
Yeah.
Because you lose your bullets quite fast. So yeah, those are reasons I use those two.
So for you guys who, for whatever kit that you put it in, is it a top 5 weapon in that kit?
No. I prefer the MP7 over the P90.
Same. Even though the MP7 has less range, I still feel more comfortable with it.
I'll take the MP5K over
it. You'll take the MP5K?
I'll even take that over the P90.
Okay, yeah. What about you, Akuma?
I would definitely use it all the time, like over the M5K and the PDWR.
I know for myself, because I use it now primarily with the recon, it's like the number one weapon. That's like my go-to weapon now for any close quarters match. It is so appropriate for any close quarters match, in my eyes, in the way I like to use it. So, it's
I would even prefer the AS Val over it.
Wow, damn!
The AS Val isn't that bad.
You know, I do too, actually.
Uh-oh.
Oh my god.
We get dissension among everybody now. We can't agree. So I think this is probably a good time to end this. So congrats to Akuma now. He's the new King of the Hill for this episode, for this week.
For now.
For now. Yeah, for now. And then so you guys in the comment section, go ahead and leave us a new weapon to look at for next time. So anyways, guys, thanks for watching. Thanks for subscribing. And we'll talk to you guys later.
All night.
And learn how to read this time. Don't pick a fake gun.
I need something to eat, but I don't have something to eat.
Oh, okay. I would suggest munching on air. That's what I do when I'm hungry.
I just fill up my stomach with water.
That's how you keep those six-pack abs like Kuma's got.
Yeah.
He's like, yeah.
You're probably all
I have a one-pack, too, but mine's bigger.
Huh? I went to the store to roll out a 6-pack.
You opted just for the one?
Yeah.
I want to be unique.
I just got a bottle.